シーホースファンブースターの皆さん、こんにちは。シーホースホームコート NC の小林拓一郎です。ようこそシーホースへ。今ですね、先ほど引退記者会見を終えた JR 桜木選手と今このオンライン上でつながっていますので呼んでみたいと思います。JR 選手、どうもお久しぶりです。
久しぶり。
今日はよろしくお願いいたします。
はい、
引退をされたんで選手ってつけるのがなんか違うのかもしれないんですけど、そこはちょっと僕の中でまだそうやって呼びたい自分もいるっていうので、ちょっと JR 選手というふうに呼んでしまいましたが、今日はよろしくお願いいたします。まず率直に今の引退されて今のお気持ちいかがでしょうか？
A bit strange, you know, because I'm in between stages, you know, I didn't have much closure, with the team, but, and the fans, but, I'm going to move on to the next phase.
いつ頃から引退というのはリアルに考えていましたか？
About a month ago, when I had a, you know, just a year-end meeting with the coach as usual, just got...talking about things and an opportunity came up and so you had to think about those opportunities there.
今こうやってオンライン上で見る限りですけれども、全然まだまだ動けるような体を持っているように見えますが、今でもあれですか、食事制限とかされてる感じですか？
Of course, it's just my way of life. I actually enjoy training, so it's no different for me. I think I can still play, of course, but
まあ、19年間というとすごく長いシーズンをこのシーホースで過ごしたことになるんですが、どこから伺っていこうかなと思うんですが、まずこの19年間振り返った時にヘッドコーチとの思い出というのはどんなことが一番印象強かったですか？
We were just both humble. When I first arrived, we were both humble as far as knowing we were challengers.And that's the way we started out together. And man, just getting over the hump and finally winning some championships together and experiencing that. And we just bonded. We just bonded like that, just, you know, coming from the bottom and going to the top. I think we just always have that connection.
19年前のもうこの日本に来た時のバスケット、そしてその時の鈴木ヘッドコーチのスタイルと、もう今これ19年だった今一番大きく変わった点ってどんなところですか？
Well, basketball as a whole has changed a lot, over the course of, you know, roughly 20 years. The pace of the game has sped up a little bit. The skill of the players has developed tremendously. And so I think, you know, overall,Basketball has just went to a different level of play.
まあ、そんな中で数々の名プレイヤーとも一緒にプレーをしてきたわけですけれども、個々のプレイヤーで見たときに、一番 JR 選手が驚いた、個々の選手でこの選手はすごいぞと驚いた選手っていうのは誰ですか？
Man, I have to split that up. There's two areas. I've been playing so long, you know.I think when I first arrived, when Sapa-san came over, I mean, it was just no contest. You know, I first saw him at Isuzu, and he was just going past the point guard just so easily, you know, and he was so smart. He played so smart, and I can relate to that, because that's how I played. You know, I was thinking the game out, and man, he had both. You know, he had skill, and he had the IQ to go with it, but in this era, there's been a lot of plays that Kanemaru-san that he's done, and that's just unbelievable. Like even in the U.S., it's just like unbelievable, like the way he shoots the ball. Like even the foreigners say it. It's just he's the best shooter we've seen, like personally.
今挙げたお二人っていうのは、まあ、世界のレベルも見てきた JR さんからしてもすごいやっぱお二人なんですね。
Oh yeah, 100%. You know, I've been around a lot of great shooters. Reggie Miller, for one. We practice against UCLA in the summers, and I mean, he's right there. You know, Ray Allen, I played against him in the playoffs in college. I've seen the top shooters in person, and you know, he's definitely one of them.
JR 選手はずっと体のコンディショニングっていうものを本当に気をつけてきたと思うんですけれども、まあ、奥さんとの出会いがすごく大きな変化だったと以前お話を聞いたことがあるんですが、やっぱりキャリアを長く続けるにはそのあたりっていうのはすごく重要になってくるんでしょうか。
Absolutely. I think it's directly connected to how your body responds to the pressure you're putting on it from playing so much, as far as the inflammation response and things like that. And the foods you eat are directly connected to that, in my experience. I've grown to be a little bit more strict and disciplined in that area, just so I can play a little bit longer.
では、最後になりますが、まあ、引退会見でもね、おっしゃってましたけど、いつか修法生って話がありましたが、息子さんが将来バスケット選手になってシーホースに来ることはあるでしょうか。
Ah, man, that would be my dream. You know, if 32 could come back in the form of Sakurai, that'd be great.
僕らもみんな嬉しいと思います。はい、見てみております。
Yeah, please keep working with your son.
Every day.
今日はお時間どうもありがとうございました。
ありがとうございます。